So with me is Brother Stephen. He is going to share not how he got healed, because that video is there. If you're interested, you can go there. But he is going to share with you after his healing how his life has changed, how his marriage is blessed, how his children are blessed, and everything has become new in his life, and how he is a blessing to people around the world. And he's not going to come and share just that. He's going to give you tips, reveal to you the system that he discovered. Because I'm not here to ask you to give a testimony, I got healed of cancer. No, 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 no. I'm here to ask him, give me the process, how you got healed, so that another person who's watching, who has got cancer, can say, hey, now I know how to mix the concrete,
yes,
how to put the concrete, and how to do the curing, and then even if somebody comes with a hammer, no change. Cancer is terminated and good health is replaced, restored completely. Now when the devil comes, the concrete understanding in the mind keeps you healthy all your life. So do you want to hear it?
Yes.
So you don't want to hear me?
We want to listen.
All these days you wanted to hear me. Now when he comes, you put me out?
No.
Your spirit.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, come brother. Do you want to set up some things? Just feel that what was the scripture where what you heard in the hospital, and go to the healing quickly, but I want to know the process. And what you're doing now.
Praise
God. Praise God. Can you come just a little? Thanks.
During my hospital stay, I have already told, I were listening to the scriptures, and there were four main things I started to confess. First one is, Lord, increase my faith. As Jesus spoke to the fig tree, Mark 11:22, the faith needs to be increased in whatever we learn and whatever we listen. Even though from childhood we are very much thorough with many scriptures and many chapters in the Bible, when there is a distress or when we are in troublesome period, only the doctor's reports and everything comes to our mind, and no other scriptures and others will not be remembered. So initially I started with writing down one verses which I hear in the messages, and although the doctor's reports and the hospital reports say I am very weak, my blood counts are less than 400, I am immune to the surroundings, and it is doctors told that you may get bleeding in stools and urine, and we are prepared for all the other things. And even though everything was there, I started confessing as in Joel 3:10, let the weak say I am strong. I started confessing, in Jesus I am perfectly healthy, strong and powerful. In Jesus I am perfectly healthy, strong and powerful. So whenever I went to the washroom, before that I started telling as many times as can, and after, during my stay, it was a long stay, like a 2 months in the hospital like that. During the stay, completely all the reports were normal, and I were having regular food, and even though in very low counts, I were having, by God's grace, I were able to consume all the food and everything, home cooked food, medicines are going, everything are going, but regularly I was able to take food.
Just tell them what you were suffering from.
Yeah, I had a lesion in my skull, and doctors were identified, and regular chemotherapy was going on, and my vision was completely blocked in 2018.
What were you suffering from?
I was suffering from blood cancer and multiple myeloma and neuroblastoma, where my calcium and excess, where everything was in excess, and my bones began to crush in every stage. And the next line I used to confess is by Jesus' wound I am completely healed. By His wounds, I am completely healed. Not I will get healed. What the spiritual world says, I am already healed. Although the thoughts and the reports, daily the reports, blood counts, and it will change daily due to the medicines and everything. When we are in the control in the hospital, automatically all the reports will come, and daily you will be bothered. Answer what is the counts, what is the all the other things, parameters and everything. But when you start confessing and other things, you are never bothered about what the actual thing is there, and you are ready to intake the word of God and learn, and you will be available for others also. And the next thing, I started to live a life of gratitude. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Trinity, when we thank God, you thank for one event, you will have many things to thank. Like, when you start thanking someone, you will find yourself cheerful in that area. You will never find a life of complaining. You will have, if you start with one thing to thank to the Lord, you will have two things immediately, and three, and it will step on. And now I am having a big list to thank for every day. And each and every day is a new day, and the whatever things you are bothered about the previous day is not going to come the next day. The Lord has forgiven everything, and you were completely healed. And so I would in Mark 11:24, my learning is, whatever you ask in prayer, shall we all read that?
Let us increase the font.
Therefore I say unto you,
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yesterday, brother was telling about a book called The Secret. many times I have attended many management meetings earlier, nearly 10 years back, and I have an English version of that book. Yeah. You will have many management lessons, and every management lesson is from the Bible. There is a verse, and the word of God clearly says by example, but whatever you ask, you believe and you will receive. The next verse, and the next verse is, and when, can you all read that? And when he stand praying, forgive if you have aught against any, that your Father also, which is in heaven, may forgive you your trespasses. So if we hold any grief or any anger with someone, and if we are holding it, we should be able to forgive unconditionally. So how we can forgive unconditionally? Only when we leave that, we will receive our healing, and each and every day-to-day activities, if we want to receive the blessings and everything, we need to forgive unconditionally the very moment. So I learned not to hold any grief and strife, whatever thing that is initiating the anger. When you are filled with the word of God, the Holy Spirit will help you come out of it and forgive unconditionally.
Amen.
Praise God. So the next learning is this, what I started to confess, Luke chapter 4:18. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
My God himself has anointed me.
Shall we all say, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The Lord himself has anointed me. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The Lord himself has anointed me. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The Lord himself has anointed me. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The Lord himself has anointed me. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The Lord himself has anointed me.
Thank you, Jesus.
So when you are, you will be pondered by worldly thoughts. Whenever you hear, you watch TV or read the newspapers, the worldly things you will be getting many things filled with your heart.
Yes.
But if when someone is asking to, when someone is asking you to share the word of God, you should be available. So make yourself available to the word of God. And only good things are coming to me, as in Romans 8:28. So I started to confess, only good things are coming to me. I am blessed, my family is blessed, my children are blessed, my friends are blessed, and my parish is blessed, my staff is blessed. So everyone you meet, you will be as a person giving light to everyone. You will be transforming the learning, and everyone who is interacting with you, you will start sharing the learning. And even if you prepare something and speak to them, the Holy Spirit will guide you what to speak to them.
Amen.
Yeah, I have tried many times. I have typed in my laptop and everything, and before that I have prayed for anointing and everything, and after I start a conversation with a person, all the things were back, and without knowing I am talking to them, and immediately the transformation is taking place. Only thing, we should be open for the learning and for the change. Every day something new is happening, and be open for the transformation and be ready to change. Praise God.
Praise God.
So, for example, being in business and interacting with many persons, whatever I see, even a small thing, if someone is telling whether I am having too much fever or some cold, automatically with my mouth it will come, put some paracetamol tablet or take some cough syrup like that. But now it is not coming like that.
Amen. Amen. What is coming?
Only the word of God is
coming. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
So it is not what we see. Without anything, we are talking about the faith. So whatever thing it is there, did be. And while having food, I started in Exodus 23:25. It is written, the Lord has, and ye shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and thy water, and I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. There shall be cause the young nor be barren in the land. The number of thy days I will fulfill. Whenever I take food, during food I used to tell, thank you Lord for blessing my food and water and taking sickness away from me. I will fulfill the number of days in my head.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
So, this small prayer, during taking any food, makes me very healthy and strong. Even though amidst many trials and other medications and other things, without bothering about what, many times I was not able to eat, and after this prayer everything is digesting properly.
Very well.
Very
good.
So this is for food and
yes.
Food, travel, everything. Even 1 week back I traveled to Bangalore for a meeting. On the day before I was not able to get from bed, but the next day I travel for a prayer meeting and return back. Praise God. So this is the thing I used to do. That is my AJP version Bible, and this is what I used to write daily. So whatever you read or you confess, there is a great connection between our writing and even one verse. If you note it down or you hear a YouTube message, just write it down. What is your learning? And write it down, the verse and the learning. And what is the action? It is like a task planning. You all would have heard about yearly planner, daily planner, like that. Whenever you go for a management meeting, they will tell me, initiate the first 3 tasks you need to finish today. Similarly, you maintain the verses, whatever you write, and maintain a journal for thanksgiving. Whatever you want to thank the Lord, thank you Jesus. Even you write one line thank you Jesus, and the scriptures, whatever you write, write it down. It takes you to greater height.
Praise God.
Really, it will be an enabler. Whatever you learn, it is reinstated. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for this precious time, and I thank God Almighty for His abundant grace and sharing the Word of God and my experiences with you all. Thank you.
Thank you.
There's something that I told him not to share, but now that we have got some more time. When you were in the hospital, what did the doctor say? Was this a last chemo? Just give us that one.
Yeah, when I was in the hospital, they were planned for multiple dosages of chemo. It is called VTD-PACE. So it is seven chemotherapy medicines mixed, and it is a very high dose chemotherapy cycle. And each cycle will be for 21 days. And during that cycle, it will be injected via vein, and four lumens will be there. And 24 hours the medicines will be going on. You will be under constant supervision. And doctors told we are going to try this, but we don't know the outcome. What will be the outcome? Whether you will be alright or it will go worse. So my sister were told, be ready for anything. Anything, complications or something, you will be shifted to the ICU. With all these medicines, normal patient, one or two medicines will be administered for chemotherapy cycles. But for such a very high dose, really it is our Lord who has blessed us and taken all the way and maintained everything very smoothly. And by the end of two cycles, when one of my doctor, who is the duty doctor there, came on that day and patted my shoulder. Doctors will be around 10 to 15 seconds only, they will come and rush and go like that. Stephen, tomorrow I am going to another ward. Tomorrow your pulse will be normal and you will be discharged. And he just went. Suddenly he returned and said, out of this 31 patients in each home, you are the only person having low counts. On that day my counts are 400. My blood counts are 400.
And how much is normal?
Normal?
Normal is above 5,000 like that.
Oh, my.
Too much?
Yeah. It was remaining like 1 week like that only. And after that, they were giving other injections to increase the counts. And he was telling, you are the person with low counts. Even with counts with more than 3,000, 4,000 where other patients having fever and other complications, but you are having more complications. No one is not taking regular food. You are taking home food. And he patted on my back and told, God is with you, man.
Praise the Lord.
Then only I realized, that is the first time I realized that with God, everything is possible.
Amen.
Praise God.
Okay, one more last. What were you confessing when the chemo was going on?
In Jesus, I am perfectly healthy, strong and powerful. In Jesus, I am perfectly healthy.
Was it at that time you heard the teaching, like the weak say, I am strong?
Yes.
That is the time you were on the chemo process going on.
Yeah, on that day only it was started. And without knowing the outcome, I started confessing actually.
Okay. And how long did you confess?
Many times.
Many times means, how many minutes, I guess?
Initially I started like telling 5 times each verse. Lord increase my faith, Lord increase my faith, and the next by in Jesus I am perfectly healthy, strong and powerful, and the next one by His wounds I am completely healed, and the fourth one, thank you Jesus, thank you Lord, thank you Jesus, thank you Holy Spirit. So every time I told a set of 5 times, and it is not daytime, nighttime and all. You won't get a regular sleep because all the medicines coming, and all the nurses and everyone will come and supervise you, and monitors are going on like that. So whenever I get up, I started confessing this. And initially I started to write. At the time there was a JCILM app available, and the confessing, and I, the word of God and everything I used to write in my note separately.
When you were taking the chemo?
Yeah, chemo. In June 18, 2018. On that time, a growth retreat was going on in
Goa.
And that is the first time I used to see YouTube in mobile. Although I am having everything in my phone, I use only for official mails and phone calls.
And that's when everything changed.
Yes.
Now, after the chemo, you drew the car from your hospital to Goa.
Yeah.
After how many days?
During November, when I was in chemotherapy schedule, I had a chemo on Saturday, and Sunday I started from Tuticorin to Goa.
How many kilometers?
1,250 kilometers.
Wow.
I want to tell one thing. It is never by our might.
Yeah. Amen.
Our might, I can't walk even out. But when our Lord is with you and the Holy Spirit, you are under His control. You can drive everywhere.
Praise the Lord.
Okay, now last one. When you came in November, you had no eyebrows, no hair, no beard, no moustache.
Yes.
What was the reason?
During chemotherapy schedule, no one will have hair and everything. When I came to the retreat Goa, and one day I came, and when brother started a prayer for me, he told one line. Because of any chemotherapy medicines, there will be no side effects.
And even if you drink deadly poison in my name, it shall not harm you.
Yes.
Mark 16, verse number 17. All those who believe in me, even if they drink deadly poison or pick up serpents, it shall not hurt
them. Them. Thank you, Jesus.
So while returning itself, till that day I never prayed for
side effects.
Yeah. I told Lord, give me the strength to overcome. And I was telling, as speaking to my mountain. And in Jesus' name, I command every cell of my body to be normal in Jesus' name.
Go to 18.
They shall take up serpents. Yeah, go ahead, brother.
We shall join in. They shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover.
And they shall die.
Recover.
They shall die.
Recover.
That's why you are not laying hands. If you believe they shall recover, then every time you are going and touching somebody and laying hands, Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So then what happened when you began to take this verse?
So after 1 week, it was in November, and in December 2nd, I were in Trichy in my sister's house, and we went to the morning, Sunday morning service, and the pastor came out and told, asked my sister, "Where is your brother?" She told me, "He's in, he immediately he got astonished and told, he is under treatment now, how come hair come?" Then only I noted, because I never used to see the mirror due to my hair.
So, hold on. You would not see the mirror because you could see all the hair had gone.
Yeah.
So looking into the mirror would be discouragement.
Yes.
So you decided, whatever is going to discourage me, I better not change my focus on that side.
Yes.
But keep focusing on the word of God.
Yes.
Amen.
And that's why you did not know what was happening.
Yes.
So when he saw, how come you got hair? That's the time you realize, oh yeah, my God, I got my hair growing.
Actually, the sister reminded him, your sister reminded you that about this verse, you had not noted.
Yeah.
Your sister reminded that,
yes,
spoke about that.
No, while driving along back, my sister told, we have never prayed that no side effects should be there. But did you listen to that prayer? They were watching online in YouTube, and she told me that while returning itself the next day, did you listen what I told? Then I also repeatedly watched that, and afterwards changed the way. I added this, and immediately whatever you ask in prayer, you believe, you receive, as in Mark 11:24.
Praise God.
Praise
God. Thank you, brother. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Of all the testimony that you said, brother, I am so sure that people will remember this one, how to grow my hair.
Praise God.
But let me tell you, how to grow your hair, that chemicals inside has destroyed your hair. And if you want to grow your hair, then take Mark 11:23 and speak to the mountain, because of which your hair is, what do you call it?
Damage.
Falling, what do you call it?
Loss of hair.
Loss of hair. So you speak to that spirit that is causing loss of hair and start speaking to your scalp. That
hair follicles.
So hair?
Hair follicles.
Hair follicles. That in the name of Jesus, begin to grow grass. Oh, sorry, not grass. Sorry. Hallelujah.
What was he doing?
Hallelujah. Now, 1 minute. Did we learn the theory part all these days?
Yes.
Did we learn how to be sensitive to the word of God?
Yes.
How the devil is trying his best to get you sensitive to the circumstances,
yes,
and harden your heart towards the word of God?
Yes.
Did you see how much time it took for this person to understand? And even after he got healed and there was no pain, you could still see, he's still amazed, how can this happen? And he's not willing to walk faster. Because the grip of our senses is so strong, it is just like a person who closes the
tap.
When you go to Ireland, whenever, they got taps which are lies.
Lies?
Their taps are always telling lies. No need. Hot and cold, but their hot tap is always telling lies.
Giving cold water, huh?
Because when you open the tap and you stay under the shower, you will run away and you will close the tap. It says hot,
very
but it course still comes cold. But I figured out why. You have to stay away from the shower and put the hot water on and wait, because all that water which was in the pipeline has to flush, and then the hot water will come. In the same way, when you take the word of God, all that unbelief has to flush out and then come to the So I lived in Ireland because they have got low temperature, about 2 or 1 and all that.